Okay. Hello, 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 everybody. Tona Live im Signal Info Show Video Edition. My name is Still Damagalch from Good Old Germany, and welcome back to our technical analysis news updates. Today, excuse me, I explored, or well, this morning, at Central European Time, 6 o'clock 26 in the morning, by the way. Excuse me, wild fresh here after. Wild fresh. I explored an idea for a proactive self-determined forex trader. So analyze the stuff again, guys, or girls, traders all around the world. It's still yours. Okay, I'm choosing the non-major one. So I'm uploaded capital market news update. So for the euro dollar, by the way, and I'm choosing here right here right now for you, and yes, non-major one, the New Zealand dollar chief. Why? Look at this. We see here the New Zealand dollar chief in a 100 pips recovery. But I'm thinking it could be much more. Could be much more. How do you say in English? Could be much more lucrative to go short, to take here an anti-cycle and contrarian position. Why? Look at this. Here we see still the 5-minute chart, and here we see the trend with here with the pivot lines, with the pivot lines, yes. So, and what's interesting for me is this one. We see here the upside trend here still on the bigger upside here. So okay, and if we zoom this a little bit, go to the 50 minutes. Yes, we see here. We are here on the above side. Here, the daily pivot line SR123. So, look at this. If we paint here, this line here, this size. We see here, if you want, perhaps I should create this in, perhaps I should create the trend line. Usually I'm trading only with the 5-minute chart, but in this one, the 15-minute chart, I see, excuse me, I'm coming out fresh from the bathroom for a few minutes, very fresh here. Here we see in a 15-minute chart, I see much more reason to sell this upside trend. And here you see why. The Bollinger Bands we are trading here on the above side, the weekly pivot points above, and the monthly here. So, and that could be, in my opinion, here. And here we see also in the 15-minute chart, here, if you want. Oh, come back, my man. Oh, come on, come down. Here, perhaps like this. Here, this divergence or this high in the oscillation. So how do you say in English? Oscillation, stochastic. Yes. Yes, here. Also, that could be perhaps a great entry point. Could be a great entry point even to sell this cross rate at these levels. So, yeah, on the 5 minutes. And here we see the upside trend, if you want, here. So, and what's also interesting from last week, here the lows at the bottom of the Bollinger line. We are here, right here now, even at the weekly pivot points. So, very interesting trading technical setup, if you want. So, and if we delete here this trend line on the right side here, then we've got here this grading, this grade setup for this week. So here we see here bear bull trend, and here the decision at the pivot point. So very interesting setup on a 50-minute basis, but here we're still trading the 5-minute basis. So let's come here. So let's come back to the 5-minute charts. Here we are. So okay, put this back in the back of your mind, and here, and come back here. Yes. And the question is, of course, how to trade. I would prefer the short side, as I said here, trading an anti, contrarian position here in the Kiwi Chief. So I would buy the Chief and sell the Kiwi, and the target should be at first here the highs of Thursday, and even get prices here to Friday's upside trend. So here the first target should be 76.72. So, and these are 40 pips, 35 pips. So, yes, here we are. Here we have in the next few minutes, we will get here the trade balance from Switzerland. It will surely got an impact. Here we are. Yesterday, we've got the performance service index in New Zealand. So, perhaps we will have here also, perhaps we will have here a trigger to break this upside trend, even from Thursday midday New York time upside trend. Yes, okay. Now I'm in the line. So I would prefer to go short in this cross rate, and here we see also why with the moving average. We see here, as I said, as a contrarian, here we see the daily moving average cross the weekly moving average, usually a bullish signal, but I would still prefer the short side, even because of this 5-minute chart. So, okay. Here we see the Bollinger Bands here. But it could also be that we go higher, but I would still prefer to go short right here, right now. At 6:31 Central European Time. So, 6:34. Meanwhile, 3 minutes here by my broker, we don't got a trade. Okay. However, if you trade, if you go short, stop, or even still go long, however, analyze this stuff again, it's still yours. Don't trade or don't take this trade without a stop. I would take the stop a little bit higher than the highs of tonight's Asia session, and these are roundabout that's round about Okay. And that's at 77.18 to be exactly. So however your risk appetite or reward is, take the stop 20, 10, 20, 30 pips here above. And the target, as I said before, should be at first to break here this upside trend from Thursday midday Central New York time. Here, then here, then here the 0.7672, and then we are here. That should be the target. So for the next 24, 48 hours. However, guys, analyze the stuff again. It's still yours. It's meanwhile 6:35 in the morning, Central European time. My name is still Damian Galsch from good old Germany. That's all for today. Have a great morning, day and night, wherever you are, and whenever you're watching my technical analysis news update, talking to roundabout while the Wall Street session today on Tuesday, the 20th November 2012. Bye bye. I'm going out.